Let's do one interesting experiment. Take a metallic plate, suspend it freely about its vertical axis. This is suspended freely here. Right? Let's do experiment. What we are doing? Now, once you have suspended this metallic plate freely, like you can see this resistor is suspended freely, you can oscillate this. So oscillate this metallic sheet freely about vertical axis. And in the first step, you measure the time. Measure the time in which oscillations are completely ceased means metallic plate comes back to its equilibrium. Let this time be T1. Note down this time. This is experiment 1. Oscillate metallic sheet again, second step. But now you oscillate this metallic sheet in presence of magnetic field. How do you produce magnetic field? You can keep two strong poles of the magnet. Oscillate this metallic sheet again and again wait till the oscillations are completely ceased or metallic sheet stops oscillating. The moment you start oscillating, please start recording time. In what time it completely comes back to its rest. Let this time be T2. Now compare these two times. You will find time T1 is greater than T2. It means this metallic sheet oscillates for a lesser time, quite lesser time, in comparison to T1, while it is oscillating freely. Now question arises, what happened in this particular case? Why does it stop oscillating so quickly while we are making it to oscillate in presence of magnetic field? Kya ho gaya bhai aisa ki achanak time T2 bahut kam ho gaya and it stops oscillating? This is actually termed as ED currents or Foucault current. Foucault's current or one pole current. Eddies, you know, that is whenever there is a cyclone, air or dust particle eddies are formed and so on. Similarly, what happens when it is allowed to oscillate in presence of magnetic field? The magnetic flux link with the coil changes and it induces large number of eddy currents loop on the surface. And these eddy currents actually stops motion. You will have one more question in your mind probably. How does it matter? Suppose eddy currents, large number of eddy currents are generated in form of large number of loops over entire surface of a metallic plate. Remember, according to Lange's law, eddy currents number 1 are induced current, and according to Lange's law, induced current are basically a conversion of mechanical energy into electrical energy. So when you oscillate metallic sheet, what kind of energy it has? Mechanical. While you are rotating and oscillating in presence of magnetic field, then its oscillating mechanical energy or oscillating energy, a portion of this energy quickly gets converted into induced current. And these are also in large number of loops. That's why a large number of mechanical energy is consumed in form of induced current. And hence, it stops oscillating quickly. Thank you. So eddy currents formula you can easily find, that is induced EMF, simple as we have done it. In general we can say 1 over R d phi b over dt, because induced EMF depends on change in magnetic flux, and the factors on which it depends we have already discussed earlier. Let's see another experiment also, that is also termed as jumping off disk. You can call it as jumping off disk. Let's take an electromagnet and this is an electromagnet connected to an alternating source. Place and keep this electromagnet vertically. This is electromagnet. Place a light metallic disc over it. This is a disc. When you switch on current in electromagnet, you will find this disc is moving up and down, jumping over the top. Instead of this this is a symbol for alternating EMF source. Instead of alternating EMF source, when you connect it with DC, it flies off quickly. Why it moves up and down? Answer is very clear. Suppose current moves in a coil from this way. So this is the upper phase of the coil. Direction of current is this. What is the direction of current? Clockwise. Clockwise current produces what kind of pole? South pole. According to Lenz's law, whenever magnetic flux changes, tendency of induced EMF is to oppose the cause. So at the lower surface of the disc, similar pole of the magnet will be formed. At upper surface of this, if it is formed south pole, then at other surface, at lower surface of the disc is also formed south pole. And since there is a repulsion between two identical poles, so it moves up. The moment it moves up, the tendency of induced EMF is to develop north pole air. So it coils back and then again moves up. Once disc start moving towards the upper phase of the electromagnet, moves up and down, moves up and down. So you can also perform this experiment, and eddy currents are practically finally gets converted into heat energy. These are radiated in the atmosphere. So eddy currents eventually gets radiated because in a heat, in form of heat, because every metallic sheet has resistance. Applications. What are the important applications of eddy currents? There are certain applications of eddy currents. These are number one, electromagnetic damping. An example of this is dead beat galvanometer. Second is induction furnaces. Third, you can say is magnetic brakes. Fourth, you can say the speedometer of cars. Speedometers of the cars. and these are also used in medical science as diathermy process. Diathermy, as it is very clear by the name, heat energy is produced, and we know that eddy currents finally gets converted into heat energy. Electromagnetic damping, where damping is reducing motion. In deadbeat galvanometer, this is very much used. How deadbeat galvanometer is different with a normal galvanometer which you see in your lab? I don't know whether you have observed it closely or not. When you make a current pass through this galvanometer, it either deflects left or right. Either side it deflects, because zero is at the center. Once you switch off current through the galvanometer, you see this needle about zero line, it oscillates for a while. This and then this and then this and then this and then finally comes to rest. It means motion of galvanometer needle is not steady. However, what do we expect? The moment current is switched off, it should stop. It should steadily come back to the zero, and therefore no oscillation. Right? This is actually happening in deadbeat galvanometer, because the excess current which is flowing an oscillating body, energy which is oscillating body, is consumed in form of forming eddy currents. Induction furnaces, I will give you a short idea of each and everything. Induction furnaces are very well used, you might have heard, in the chemistry, because these are used to produce high temperatures which are utilized in preparing alloys by melting the constituent metals. A high frequency alternating current is passed through a coil surrounds the constituent metals. The large number of eddy currents are produced on the surface of metal, right? And therefore, these eddy currents are producing large amount of heat energy correspondingly, and eventually metal melts. I'm not making induction furnace diagram. Magnetic brakes are very powerful brakes, and some of the electric trains are using these magnetic brakes. These brakes are much, much powerful brakes, and based on production of eddy currents. So what happens when electromagnets are activated? These are switched. You can see in electromagnet, I can explain you little with diagram. This is a wheel is connected with an axle, and over this axle there is a metallic cylinder. Over this metallic cylinder there are magnetic poles. This is wheel. So when train is moving on a track, this wheel rotates, eventually metallic cylinder also rotates while it is moving. And how these poles, electromagnetic poles, are activated? The moment driver applies brake, these are activated. So magnetic field falls on cylinder. The moment magnetic field falls on this rotating cylinder, since it is metallic, large number of induced currents are set up on the surface of this metallic cylinder, and eventually the mechanical energy of moving train is getting converted into heat energy. So this energy is radiated into atmosphere, and this wheel stops moving after some time. But it's a very powerful brake. you can cannot compare with a normal brake or cycle brake, obviously. Even in the speedometer of motorbike or vehicles, you can check it. The moment you press accelerator, the needle moves steadily up, and on releasing accelerator, the needle comes down steadily. It doesn't happen in case of speedometer, that while you are trying to increase or accelerate your car, the needle vibrates. No. It is also because of the fact, because there is an aluminium cylinder on which eddy currents are produced, and so excessive energy, mechanical energy is consumed. So no oscillation, extra oscillations and vibration in the needle. Diathermy is a technique which is used for deep treatment of the human body in hospitals. And what is deep treatment of the human body? Wherever we need heat energy to burn the tissues, undesirable tissues, we use this diathermy. Or as we know, in case eddy currents, by producing eddy currents, you can easily generate heat energy. So diathermy is very well used there also.